Good morning and welcome on this glorious Monday morning. What a great weekend. We celebrated the 10th Sunday after Pentecost as we heard from our Lord and Savior how he comes to us, how he came to Peter on the water and immediately saved him. And this week, our devotions, we're gonna go back to the book, The Treasury of Daily Prayers, and we're spending some time in Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, and then there will be a writing each day that I'll read, whether it be, today's is gonna be from the Apology of the Augsburg Confession. Tomorrow's gonna be a writing from Martin Luther, one from the Large Catechism, so we're gonna be kind of delving a little bit into the Book of Concord for some of our writings, and then prayer. So that'll be kind of the format of this week, and please let me know how you like it, and we may continue it next week when I'm up in Wisconsin, or we may go to a different book of the Bible and go back and do that again. But it is so good having all of you with us. We miss you. We love you. And my time was, as I head up to Wisconsin early this week, I will miss each of you. And as I told my wife, I'm looking forward to seeing her. So Brandy sends her love to all of you, and God be with you. So let us begin this morning, as we always do, with Luther's morning prayer. I thank you, my Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have kept me this night from all harm and danger. And I pray that you would keep me this day also from sin and every evil, that all my doings in life may please you. For into your hands I commend myself, my body and soul and all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen. All right, so we are starting out today, 1 Corinthians, for those of you who have your Bible along, beginning with chapter 3, verse 1. But I, brothers, could not address you as spiritual people, but as people of the flesh, as infants in Christ. I fed you with milk, not solid food, for you were not ready for it. And even now you are not yet ready, for you are still of the flesh. For while there is jealousy and strife among you, are you not of the flesh and behaving only in a human way? For when one says, I follow Paul, and another, I follow Apollos, are you not being merely human? What then is Apollos? What is Paul? Servants through whom you believed, as the Lord assigned to each. I planted, Apollos watered, but God gave the growth. So neither he who plants nor he who waters is anything, but only God who gives the growth. He who plants and he who waters are one, and each will receive his wages according to his labor. For we are God's fellow workers. You are God's field, God's building. According to the grace of God given to me, like a skilled master builder, I laid a foundation and someone else is building upon it. Let each one take care how he builds upon it. For no one can lay a foundation other than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now if anyone builds on the foundation with gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, straw, each one's work will become manifest. For the day will disclose it, because it will be revealed by fire. And the fire will test what sort of work each one has done. If the work that anyone has built on the foundation survives, he will receive a reward. If anyone's work is burned up, he will suffer loss, though he himself will be saved, but only as through fire. Do you not know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy him. For God's temple is holy, and you are that temple. Let no one deceive himself. If anyone among you thinks he is wise in this age, let him become a fool that he may become wise. For the wisdom of this world is folly with God. For it is written, he catches the wise in their craftiness. And again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, that they are futile. So let no one boast in men, for all things are yours, whether Paul or Apollos or Cephas or the world or life or death or the present or the future. All are yours, and you are Christ's, and Christ is God's. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And boy, wonderful word. And I love when we read the epistles and I just sit back and imagine myself unrolling that scroll, that letter, and just hearing that impassioned plea from Paul or from Peter or any of the other writers of the epistles, the general epistles. But here's what the Apology of the Augsburg Confession in Article 5, Section 3 says. Good works are to be done because of God's command and for the exercise of faith. Confessing the faith and giving thanks. Because of Christ, they are holy. Divine works, sacrifices, and acts belonging to the rule of Christ, who in this way displays his kingdom before this world, in order to retain the gospel among people. He openly sets the confession of saints against the kingdom of the devil, and in our weakness declares his power. Consider the dangers, labors, and sermons of the Apostle Paul, of Athanasius, Augustine, and the rest who taught the churches. These deeds are holy works and true sacrifices acceptable to God. They are Christ's battles through which he repressed the devil and drove him away from those who believed. David's labors in waging wars and in his home government are holy works, true sacrifices, and battles fought by God. They defend the people who had God's word against the devil in order that the knowledge of God might not be entirely extinguished on earth. We think this way also about every good work in the humblest callings and in private affairs. To demean such works, the confession of doctrine, sufferings, works of love, suppressions of the flesh, would be to demean the outward rule of Christ's kingdom among people. Here also we add something about rewards and merits. We teach that rewards have been offered and promised for the works of believers. We teach that good works have merit, not for the forgiveness of sins, for grace, or for justification, for these we receive only through faith, but for other rewards, bodily and spiritual, in this life and after this life. For Paul says in 1 Corinthians 3:8, each will receive his wages according to his labor. There will be different rewards according to different labors, but forgiveness of sins is given alike and equal to all people, just as Christ is one and is offered freely to all who believe, that for his sake their sins are forgiven. And so, beautiful writing today coming from the Apology of the Augsburg Confession, and just reminding us that there's nothing that we can do to earn forgiveness of sins. God gives it freely to us when we repent of our sins. Just as Christ's righteousness is counted to us as our righteousness, and salvation is freely given to all who believe. What a beautiful thing. So let's go to the Lord this morning in prayer. Lord Jesus, you have joined us to yourself in holy baptism and made our bodies a temple of your Holy Spirit. May the fruit of the Spirit be born in our bodies as we show forth in the world your love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. For against such things there is no law. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Well, blessings to each of you on this glorious Monday morning. At least here in Lakefield, it's quite overcast. The wind has stopped. Maybe that's the calm before the storm. But what a glorious day, waking up and starting our day in God's Word and being reminded that we are redeemed children. We are one in the body of Christ. And the foundation that we've been built on is Jesus Christ. So go in peace today and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.